All right, it's another edition of Comic Con Carne. This is the only show of its kind on YouTube, as far as we know. Now, yes, there are a lot of shows on YouTube where people talk about comics. They tell you what they think, they tell you how they feel, what they like, what they don't like. People talk about comics the way Siskel and Ebert talk about movies. They give you opinions. We're more like Entertainment Tonight. We give you news. So let's get to it, because we've got a lot of news. We got sales numbers for 2012 from Diamond. Guess what? DC's still number two, just saying. Now, usually we have new titles to announce here on the show. This time we have new publishers, too. Amigo Comics hits the stands in April. Their first title, Rogues, tells the tales of a couple of thieves who rescue a girl and fall under a curse. Publisher El Torres says it may not be the best time to launch a new publishing company with the economy being the way it is, and with most of the talent in Spain. But they have a lot of stories to tell, and they're diving in with both feet. Currently, all of the titles are for mature readers only, but eventually they'll get around to other ages. You can find out more at amigocomics.com. And Atomica Press returns. Dave Elliott has teamed up with Titan Comics to revive the A1 anthology series starting in June. It'll have three ongoing stories inside, and will also be available day and date through your digital device using the Comixology app. And it is the end of an era. The Comics Buyer's Guide, which has been around since 1971, will put out its last issue, number 1699, this March. Krauss Publications cited the downturn in print advertising, so much free content online, they just can't compete anymore in such a specialized industry. Now, from financial to legal, which also gets us into DC. In our first ever Silver Screen edition, we told you one of the Smallville lawsuits has been settled. Now this is the big one. The Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals has ruled in favor of Warner Brothers in the decade-plus legal battle with the Siegel estate. Specifically, the deal that was put into place in 2001 is legally binding. This, plus the ruling last October involving the Schuster estate, pretty much wraps up about 65 years of legal battles, except for the Warner Brothers lawsuit against lawyer Mark Toberoff for misconduct. Free Comic Book Day is just around the corner. DC has released the cover to The Superman Offering. It's the first chapter of the graphic novel Superman, Last Son of Krypton, written by Richard Donner and Jeff Johns, art by Adam Kubert, plus a sneak peek at the new Superman title, Man of Steel, by Scott Snyder and Jim Lee. Now, we've heard of Scott Snyder. He was writing Swamp Thing, but now he's not. Issue 19 will be the debut of Charles Soule, not an entirely familiar name unless you've seen 27 or Strange Attractors. He's very excited about it, looking forward to taking the Avatar of the Green in lots of different directions after the Rot World story, including some rather well-known guest stars. Now, last time we talked about Jeff Lemire picking up a new title in the New 52. Turns out it's Green Arrow, and he's taking the character back to square one when his run starts in issue 17. All of Ollie's money and power are stripped away. There's a new villain, an archer named Komodo. Lemire says, quote, "Anyone who hasn't been reading the book yet since the New 52 launch doesn't need to worry about what's going on." So everything that's happened before issue 17 doesn't matter because he's rebooting the reboot. Lemire's also jumping into the DC revolving door, co-writing the DC version of Constantine with Ray Fox, who was going to replace Gail Simone on Batgirl until Gail Simone replaced Gail Simone on Jim Zubkovich isn't going to be writing Birds of Prey. He's been replaced before he could even start by Christy Marks, who's been having a well-received run on Sword of Sorcery. At least Zub didn't find out by email. Meanwhile, he's writing the monthly reboots of Skull Kickers over at Image, and the marketing gag on this is priceless. Writer Jim Starlin is going to Stormwatch, like everyone speculated. Now, the new DC titles to replace the canceled iVampire, Superman Family Adventures, and DC Universe Presents. First, He-Man, written by Keith Giffen, with art by Popman. Giffen's currently writing the Masters of the Universe mini. And did you know 2013 is He-Man's 30th anniversary? 30. Feel old now. There's a new hardcover collection of the original Watchmen coming out May 29th, and you might be surprised to find a brand new introduction to the collection by artist Dave Gibbons. Now, you may recall, Gibbons seemed less than enthusiastic when talking to the press about the Before Watchmen project, and we talked to him about other work way a long time ago. If you want to hear that interview, there's a link in the show notes. And what's going on for Vertigo now that Karen Berger is out? What do you think is going to happen to the imprint? Give us a comment. Share with the group. And this is Detective Comics number 900, or it would have been if the New 52 hadn't happened. It's actually Detective 19. It's titled Mystery of the 900, and it's an oversized 80 pages, just with the wrong issue number on it. And we all know one of Batman's influences is Zorro, and Hermes Press has collected Alex Toth's short run on the Dell comic book in a deluxe reprint, 7 issues, 240 pages, art by the legendary Alex Toth. Now, let's look at Marvel. Omega Flight is back as of Avengers number 10, coming out in April, and a new set of mini-mates, this one featuring Marvel Now versions of the characters. Set 51 kicks off another 10-year run with Diamond Select Toys. Eisner Award-winning artist Francesco Francavilla will join Matt Fraction for 2 issues of Hawkeye, starting in April. And Captain Marvel will have a big crossover event with the Avengers. This is Carol Danvers, not Billy Batson. And we got a tease that Spider-Man 2099 might be showing up in the new Doc Ock Spidey book. Also in the solicitations, more details on the Age of Ultron event, plus the new Universe initiative from the 80s is back. It looks like Jonathan Hickman is bringing it back in a fairly substantial way. And now, two non-Now X titles are going away. Age of Apocalypse and Extreme X-Men will be ending in April. Okay, now that's the big two out of the way. Don't forget the Silver Screen edition of Comic Con Carne, hosted by Rena. She's got all the comic book, movie, and TV news. That's on the third Thursday of every month, unless you want us to do more. Boom Studios has announced a new 4-issue miniseries called Polarity, written by Max Bemis, lead singer for the band Say Anything. It's the story of Timothy Woods, a bipolar artist who learns his bipolar disorder is actually connected to his superpowers. Debuts in April, and every issue comes with a free download of a new original song specifically written for the project, not available anywhere else. Valiant Comics has their first big crossover in April, The Harbinger Wars. It's Valiant's first big superhuman showdown. It crosses over to the Harbinger and Bloodshot solo books with the two characters on a collision course. Also in May, Dark Horse debuts Hunter Quaid. The press release calls him a drunken, misanthropic, time-traveling detective from the 40s. Written by Donnie Cates and Elliot Rahal, it started with an elevator pitch at Comic-Con. So when you guys go to these things, have your pitches ready. You never know what'll happen. Image Comics has a new director of business development, Ron Richards, the co-founder of iFanboy.com, which recently moved back to independent blog status after a few years under the ownership of Graphically. Richards will be working on sales and marketing for Image, and Paul Montgomery will take on editorial duties at iFanboy. See what happens when you start a blog? And get recruited. We have a blog. If you're in the Seattle area, Phoenix Jones is recruiting for the real-life superhero movement. But he doesn't want reporters. You can watch his pitch video by following the link. And you can follow us here on YouTube by subscribing. As always, we welcome your comments. We're also on the Facebook and the Twitterverses, and now on Pinterest. Don't forget the Silver Screen Edition every third Thursday, Prime Edition every second and fourth Thursday, and Ink Tips will be back next month. And if you're into video games, don't miss The Grid every first Wednesday of the month starting February 6th. For the latest science fiction and fantasy news, reviews, recaps, and other such like things, you can check us out at scififorme.com. That's it for this one. We will see you next month.